Hey Downsies, it's David Desai. Welcome back to my channel. Today I want to get into the news of Jungkook and Ariana Grande, along with a lot of other people coming together. It's very crazy and cool news. A lot of people have been hoping for a Jungkook and Ariana Grande collab for a while now, and it may happen now. We also made another Big Hit Billboard protest truck parked outside, and Big Hit did actually release a statement, so I want to talk about that and get into it. So grab your Dumpling Tea Spilling Mug merch, and let's get into the tea. If you are new here and you're interested in this type of stuff, please make sure to hit the subscribe button and that notification bell to be notified anytime a new video drops. And if he's a hater, like to be the first of your hate comment, please make sure you hit the subscribe button and that notification bell also so you can be first to do so. Now let's jump into it. The first thing I want to get into is what is going on with Big Hit, or specifically HYBE. So let me clarify so there's no confusion. HYBE is an umbrella company. It holds Big Hit Music, which is where BTS directly works out of. And HYBE has all these divisions, like real estate and other endeavors they're trying to do, which hold Big Hit and a lot of other companies. So I woke up this morning to some of the craziest news. Let's just say at this point, Big Hit and BTS have really dug their roots into the ground, and they will be going nowhere. Their kids are still going to be relevant and super rich. So HYBE was trending this morning on the Tweetster with over 200,000 tweets and a bunch of people freaking out. It was officially announced that Bang PD Daddy has merged with Ithaca Records. This is the record label with Justin Bieber, Demi Lovato, and of course Ariana Grande. This obviously caused fans to freak out because they have been wanting BTS, or specifically Jungkook, to work with Justin Bieber and Ariana Grande. But before we get into that, it's absolutely crazy that HYBE would be merging with all these amazingly talented artists, and just the amount of gold that will come out of this. Big Hit Daddy actually released an official statement, followed by when the news broke. He said this: "The two companies will work closely together, leveraging our proven track records of success, know-how, and expertise to create synergy, transcend borders, and break down cultural barriers. Please look forward to the endless possibility of HYBE and Ithaca Holdings, and the new paradigm the partnership will establish in the music industry." And big emphasis on endless possibilities. This definitely means new opportunity for music. This means new opportunity for the boys to collab with all these artists. I know Jungkook said he's working on a mixtape bag. So is it too much to expect or hope that this could be a confirmation that maybe Jungkook and Ariana Grande can work together now? I mean, Ariana's married, so there's no chance for a date and rumors. And they would just make such an amazing track. ARMYs have been shipping and even creating photos of them together for a long time. There was even this long-standing joke that Ariana wanted to collab with Jungkook so badly that she edited a selfie of them together, like Photoshop Jungkook next to her, which of course is false because they did indeed meet. And honestly, it looks like a real photo to me. A lot of people on the Tweetster were so happy to hear about this. We're so happy to hear about this new possibility. One person wrote, "Jungkook, I beg you, can you send a quick text to Ariana Grande and like make a song together? Thanks." Right, let's just go to Bang PD Daddy and get that number and just, "Hey Ari, I know you busy, but like Jungkook x Ariana Grande song." And Ariana would totally understand and she'd be like, "Yes queen, send it." Bad Ariana impression, she doesn't talk like that. But something that a lot of people were 100% hyped for. I honestly can't even wait. Like, you can't be so vague to be like endless possibilities. You gonna make my mind go to those endless possibilities. Like, I'll think of every possibility. A lot of ARMYs were even looking at the list of artists under HYBE now and hoping for a collab with those artists. Some ARMYs wrote, "Jungkook and Ariana Grande collab, Jungkook and Justin Bieber collab, Jungkook and Tori Kelly collab, when?" Tori Kelly would be amazing to work with Jungkook. They both have great voices. Tori can also go really high, so it would just blend very well with Cookie. "I am hoping for a collab on Jungkook's mixtape. More importantly, I would love a collab and hear about collabs on Taeyong's mixtape. I feel like his mixtape might actually come out first." Of course, there is a concern with all this new stuff that is happening. There could be artists or even BTS that might fall through the cracks. Obviously, when a label has like three artists in there, then Bang PD can focus on just those artists and make everything perfect. But that's not an entirely correct way of thinking. There was this chart that was made and explained everything really well. So HYBE owns Big Hit and then Big Hit America. And then beneath all of that is the American label with the American artists in them. Those labels were running fine without HYBE. There's no surprise there. So the team will likely still work and do their job as usual, and they would run it as normal. Meaning Bang PD probably wouldn't have to put all of his time in those artists and can still spend his time managing HYBE, BTS, along with TXT and Hypen and all that. So I think everyone will get good attention from Bang PD. But what benefit does merging have? It expands their network a lot. So obviously there's more resources and connections that HYBE will have in America, i.e. connections to TV, radio, and all that that will essentially help BTS too. A TV company isn't going to be like, "Oh no, don't put BTS on the shows, those are those Korean men." When the TV company realizes BTS is signed to the same label as Justin Bieber, they're going to be like, "Oh yes, put them on." Also, this might give BTS a bigger chance with the Grammy. An insider, I think it was Halsey, spoke about how the Grammys are more determined by who you know in the industry. And if BTS becomes more connected with the American industry, then their chances increase a lot for the next year. That is my theory, by the way. I do not have inside information. This is alleged, my conspiracy. Exciting, exciting news. Apparently this happened, and then in the midst of that, there were some billboard trucks outside of Seoul Dragon City Hotel that apparently happened on March 30th. So there was this shareholder meeting for Big Hit Music. I don't know exactly what they were there to talk about or if they had anything to do with the American label thing. But apparently people found out there was going to be a meeting and decided to pay several amounts of money to get a billboard truck outside of the hotel. The billboard was about Jimin's recent hate he's getting online and the recent allegations made towards him. So apparently there's blogs and comments in forums and they are really bad and should be taken down. I agree. They should not be written. And people who write these things need to go to therapy, seriously. But I've said this before, but it's an actual waste of money for the billboard, but also for Big Hit to put in their time and money into lawyers for this. I think what the fandom can do, and I mean for all of K-pop, is to educate viewers and the fandom to not just falsely believe dumb allegations. Do your research, watch the video, and actually listen before making an assumption. Why isn't this something that's more widely talked about? I feel like I'm the only commentary channel that's encouraged people to do their research and stop spreading mindless hate. If you were to say some really bad Justin Bieber allegations to believers, they wouldn't even kind of believe you because they do their research a little bit. So we need to understand and realize there's a problem here. If people who are K-pop stans are just so quick to jump at things without seeing the whole facts. Also, I'm not sure of the law in Korea, but in America, death threats are illegal. Meaning yes, everyone who has sent death threats to me, I can legally get an investigator and put you in jail. And Big Hit can do that to anyone sending death threats. But not only Big Hit, you as the fans can too because it's illegal. Why don't you take that money for the billboard and do that? And if it's something you can't legally do anything about, then Big Hit can't either. At least I don't think. Again, the law might be different in Korea, but I can't imagine if something is blatantly illegal and threatening that it has to be the one being threatened that can take action, that no bystanders watching can do anything about it. Billboard truck continued to say that if no action is taken by Big Hit by the end of April, they will continue the truck in May. Big Hit did release a statement, as per usual. They said that they are looking into it, but I don't think this billboard thing is ever going to end. I think it's literally impossible to get all of the commenters. BTS is huge. We're talking potentially hundreds of thousands of death threats and hate comments. How do you expect them to do this? There's probably blogs out there of American artist singers that have bad things written about the singer, and nothing can be done about it. And the artists will have to continue their life. Michael Jackson had horrible, horrible things written about him. When he died, he was still remembered as one of the best singers and pop icons ever. Even to this day, his music is just amazing. So I don't think these awful comments are hurting BTS in any way. And I think this is just too much. Honestly, it's overwhelming. As you can see, the label is dealing with a lot on their plate right now. Let me know what you think. Let me know what your thoughts are. Leave it down in the comment section down below. Give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. And I'm featuring it in this comment right here. Thank you so much for your time. And as always, I do have a Patreon if you want to go over there and check stuff out. I have a lot of videos over there that I can't really post on here. This is due to copyright or getting taken down, so I do keep it over there on my Patreon. You can get reaction videos over there like music video reactions, performance reactions, ship reactions. You can also recommend things you'd like to see over there. Link is in the top description down below. I also have another video over there that's free to watch on the front page. Kind of talks about Asian in media and kind of my experience and all that, so make sure you go ahead and check it out. It also explains a little bit about how you can contribute back to this channel if you would like. With that said, there's two videos that will appear up on screen at the end of this video, so click on one of those and I'll see you over there. Bye.